Okay, so we're looking at factorial notation today because, as I've been saying in the last couple lessons, there are many different sequences, and there are some sequences that deal with factorials. And so factorials themselves are a sequence, and it's about adding numbers. We look at it as products. Okay? So n factorial is defined as 1 times 2 times 3 times 4 times whatever numbers you need to get up to whatever n is going to be, and can be 10. If n is, let's say, 3, then you're really just doing 1 times 2 times 3. Many students do something like this. And it's 3 times 2 times 1, and that's perfectly fine. But this actually leads into another definition for n factorial, and this is an important one. Okay, so n factorial is defined this way. It is also defined as n times the quantity of n minus 1 factorial. Okay, n minus 1 means it's 1 less than n, so this is basically describing, in the case of 3 factorial, the 2 factorial, which is 2 times 1. Okay, if we were talking about 5 factorial, then this would be 5 times 4 factorial, okay, which is 5 times 4 factorial, which is 4 times 3 times 2 times 1. Okay? So this is another way to write n factorial. Now, I just want to bring to this special case, 0 factorial is 1. Many students forget that. They assume that 0 factorial is 0. So let's see why. Okay, first off, let's take a look at doing 6 factorial. So we just discussed 5 factorial. So, okay, let me do 6 factorial with the first definition here. That's going to be 1 times 2 times 3 times 4 times 5 times 6. Okay, so if we were to multiply this out, we have 24 times 30, so this gives us an answer of 720. So that's 6 factorial. Most students can figure that out, not too bad, and most students know 1 factorial is just the 1 that we have here. It's just that number itself. So we know 6 factorial is 720. And we know 1 factorial is 1. So why in the world is 0 factorial 1? And the reason actually goes along with understanding 1 factorial is 1 and this definition of n factorial. So here we go. I'm going to erase all of this. So I have room to show you. Okay. If n factorial is n times the quantity n minus 1 factorial, and we're trying to do 0 factorial. Oh, we're trying to prove 0 factorial. Let's talk about 1 factorial. This is one that we know the answer to. Okay, that is 1. 1 factorial is going to be 1 times 1 minus 1 factorial, which is 0 factorial. Well, we know that any number times 1 is going to be itself. So this brings us to the fact that 1 is equal to 0 factorial. Okay, so 6 factorial may be 720. 1 factorial may be 1, but 0 factorial is also 1. You don't have to always prove it, but you do have to know it. So we have example one, and there is an ABC, so we're going to be doing each one of these. So in example one, part A, we have here A sub n is equal to n plus 2, I'm sorry, the quantity of n plus 2 factorial over n factorial. So if we want to find the first five terms, we'd be doing this. And calculating what each one is. I apologize, it seems a little sloppy, but you can see that just like previous lessons, you're just doing a substitution. Okay. And then we can calculate what each one is. So if we were to calculate what each one is, this is actually going to be 6. And that's 12. And that's 20. And that's 30. And that's 42. You may be taking out a calculator to figure this out, but you don't need to. So I want to look at example 1, part B. So in this, we have 6 factorial over 4 factorial. So we have the idea that 6 factorial is going to be 1 times all the way up to 6. And that includes 1 times 2 times 3 times 4. Okay? So what happens since we're dealing with factorials is that if you have one over the other, you can cancel factors because they can go into itself one time. So if I put here it's 1 times dot 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 4 times 5 times 6, we can easily see how these can cancel and be 1. So 1 times 5 times 6 is 30, and if you put that over 1, it's just 30. So that is an easy way to figure out how to do factorials when we have both the numerator and denominator in that format. So this is actually how we can figure out a sub 4 right there. But I want to bring your attention to example 1, part C, and then we'll go back to part A again. So in example 1, part C, notice that it has the factorial of 2n factorial in the denominator. Okay, we just are evaluating the expression, that we don't have to find any terms here. So basically it's a way of simplifying it. And I should have left space there. All right. I can fill this in. It's not a problem. So you saw how I was talking about, you know, the 1 times, you know, dots, dots, dots of 4. So I'm trying to put that in here. Now, 2n, we were talking about notation and where it is. 2n is actually larger than 2n minus 3. So that's why I'm starting with the denominator. I want to extend this out since this is larger. 2n minus 3 is 3 terms before it. So obviously it's going to be smaller. Okay? So you have to think very carefully about the notation when you do these problems. So we have 2n minus 3, which is smaller than 2n minus 2, and which is smaller than 2n minus 1. Think of the number line, then we would have 2n, okay? So that's 1 term before it, that's 2 terms before it, 3 terms before it, okay? Well, this right here is 2n minus 3 factorial. So in the idea of canceling out factors like we did over here, we're going to cancel out this factorial with this right here because they are equivalent. Again, when you cancel, and it's something that could go into itself, we're left with 1. So the answer for C is that we can evaluate this expression to be 1 over, because we canceled, that would be 1, the product of 2n minus 2, 2n minus 1, and 2n. Okay? So this is just basically example 1 part B, just without the numbers. Okay? And I said I was going to go back to example 1, and I am. So in example 1, I'm going to kind of do the same thing. So that way I can actually calculate each one of these, okay, much quicker and easier than before. And I may be thinking I'm crazy, but I'm not. So if I go back to example 1, and I was going to rewrite a sub n, okay? I'm going to actually rewrite it as n plus 1 times n plus 2, or the quantity of n plus 1 times the quantity of n plus 2. Here's why. So in this case, the larger one, since it's 2 units after, this is the larger one, and I'm going to expand the larger one to show that I have n factorial times n plus 1 times n plus 2. The smaller one stays, and again, cancel. So that's my expression. I have n plus 1 times, that's supposed to be 2, n plus 2. That's my a sub n. So if I want to figure out all of these, I don't have to figure out the long factorials and cancel it out the long way. Each one of these is simply n plus 1 times n plus 2. This one, where n is 2, it's going to be the quantity of 2 plus 1 times the quantity of 2 plus 2. You can easily see it's 3 times 4. Of course, that's 12. So this makes your life a lot easier if you can simplify. And it's so important that you know how to simplify your expressions when they are factorials. So now you are ready to understand how quick and easy some of these are and do some practice problems.